the community is going to be safeguarded by current legislation, and that's impaired driving laws that exist today, and then of course some provincial statute laws that allow us to do vehicle seizures and suspend drivers. We don't know what training will come directly to the province or to the Saskatoon Police Service for training, and often training costs are soft costs. They're not just, you know, the registration for a training course. We have officers who are no longer available to do enforcement initiatives in the city and have to be backfilled, or there's the lack of resources. So there's a lot of unknown costs right now. Another unknown, of course, is what will happen with offending rates when marijuana is legal and available to the public. So we know from our analysis of other areas where they've legalized marijuana, offending rates in some areas like impaired driving have gone up, and that takes additional resources around education, training for our officers, and of course enforcement and related costs to that. So this is, we're in a learning phase here. We have to wait and see what impact marijuana is going to have on offending and what that's going to mean for resourcing Saskatoon Police Service. Well, I hope, I guess, first of all, an understanding again that it's still illegal, and there's no lawful way for somebody to have cannabis for sale at this point. So the fact that it's being discussed, the fact that it's going to be lawful, doesn't erase that. So if you're purchasing cannabis without a prescription right now, that cannabis comes from an illegal source, and so there's no regulation around it, and we encourage people not to do that. If you require cannabis, please see a physician and take his advice and pardon me, follow the medical process for that. When we do roll it out, we hope and we'll participate in education, so that people, when cannabis is available as a family, as an individual, as a community, you'll be informed about cannabis and you can make your own decisions on it from there. That's, I think, the message from the Saskatoon Police Service at this point.